safety at sea is very important. And by adding a radar to the Simrad NSX, it now allows you to see land masses, track targets at sea, watch storm fronts. So this will give you that extra peace of mind while you're on the water. So we're gonna walk you through how to set it up and how to view and manage that data. Okay, so once you've installed your radar, we do need to go into the NSX and we need to walk you through how to set it up properly. So through the home page, you're gonna go to settings, and you're gonna notice we have setup guide. And setup guide is gonna have the setups for whatever devices you have attached. So we've already gone through the sounder setup, so now we're going into radar setup. And you notice it has an at dock and on the water. Certain products do need to be set up while they're stationary, and stuff like the radar does need to be set up when it is actually out on the water. We need some additional features that need to be set up. So when we start walking through the dockside setup, device name, we're running a simulator here, but I'm gonna call this a Halo radar. I'm gonna hit start. Okay, it's an open array. I've got a 4-foot array on it. Now park angle. Park angle is where do you want the array to stop when you're done transmitting? And you notice we're gonna walk you through both with textual as well as visual pictures. So do I want it to stop at the zero marker, 90? I want it to stop at 90 for me. So I'm gonna put it in there, and it depends. Trailering boats, you may want it to set at zero so there's less chances of hitting tree branches and stuff like that. But again, it's all personal preference. Then what's your antenna height? So mine is gonna be 13 feet off the water. Go through next. Okay, do I wanna turn on the accent light? So in the Halos, they have a blue accent light. You have the ability to turn it on low, medium, or high. Now, once you turn it on, doesn't mean you can't turn it back off without having to jump through a lot of steps. You can do it through the software, turn it off very easily. So I'm just gonna put mine on low. We'll continue on. Okay, so it tells me we need to now go out and do a sea trial to calibrate the device. So now we're ready to do our sea trial or on the water. So we'll tap on the water. And we can begin transmitting. So the first thing we're gonna come up to is sector blanking. Sector blanking is where there's an area that we don't want the radar to transmit. This could be caused by obstructions like tower legs or antennas that could cause erroneous signal return. Or it could be things like satellite communication devices like a SATCOM or satellite television where we don't want to transmit into that device. So we can simply hit add a sector. We can now control how wide or where we want to move that to. So we simply find out. We obviously want to make it as small as possible because as you can see, as it gets further and further away, we're going to lose more and more information. So you want to just make sure it's just that small area that that device is that's either causing an error or we don't want to transmit into. Once that's done, add sector, we'll add another one. We can do up to 4. Then we go on to our next step, and that is range offset. So if you start reading, it's gonna tell you to go along a seawall, and we're gonna adjust that timing sequence so that we make a seawall straight. But you notice that as we move through it, you've got some contextual information to help you understand, and then you simply go in and add or increase that range offset until that seawall that we're running up against is looking nice and straight and not bowed in or bowed out. Simply hit check and we go on to our next step. Now this is bearing alignment. This is where we're gonna find a small buoy or boat that's stationary and we're gonna put it right, wanna make sure it lines up right on the center line here. How we're gonna do that is we're gonna stand dead center of the boat looking straight down the bow, steer the boat, and depending on where that target is, we're gonna go in and adjust plus or minus, and that's gonna actually rotate plus or minus 30 degrees or whatever you put that up to. It shouldn't be very large. But what you're gonna do is keep adjusting that till that target is sitting right dead center of that line. We're gonna hit select, and we're gonna go on. Sidelobe suppression. Again, if you're seeing any false arcs or returns, you're gonna go in and do some adjustment on sidelobe suppression. In most cases, you do not really need to touch sidelobe suppression. This is only in the event we get some adverse conditions caused by the vessel. Local interference rejection. So this is again, if you have multiple radars transmitting in the same area, you might get some false targets from them. So you do have the ability to adjust that at first time. So if you, the vessel, has two radars on there, you might want to automatically set this up at a certain level. In most cases, you won't. You'll leave it off or low, and then you'll be able to do it in the menu as you're out on the water. And now it tells us we're ready to run our radar. So now that we've done that, you notice that the setup menu is now gone, tells me that we've done all the setup features that need to happen, and now we're ready to take it out on the water and use it.